Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
No man is going to deliver us in these last days. Y'all brothers got questions?
He want to know who's going to be saved and how the Gentiles not going to be saved. Like, only Israelites.
He want to know who's going to be saved. All right. Let's get that in Romans. Romans 11. First, and then we'll deal with the second part is, you say, why are the Gentiles not going to be saved? Okay, the natural Gentiles are not going to be saved. We read it earlier in Psalms 147 and 19 that the Bible was given to the Israelites, Blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans. Because you got to remember, this is our book. Like, for example, Hinduism. Who practices Hinduism? Asians. That's their religion, right? That's their God. That's their practices, their culture, their heritage, right? This is our heritage.
That's right.
We're not gonna say, hey, why won't Hinduism save me? That's not my book. That's not my religion, right? I'm not looking for their God to save me. I'm looking for my God to save me. You understand? All right, read what you got.
Romans chapter 11, verse 26.
Yep.
And so all Israel shall be saved. As it is written, there shall come out of Zion the deliverer, and shall turn away ungodliness from Jacob.
Read that again from the top.
And so all Israel,
who?
All Israel,
who?
All Israel, be saved.
Shall be what?
Shall be saved.
So all the Bible is clear. We can stop right there, close the Bible, and walk off the corner. All Israel is going to be saved if we repent and keep the commandments.
That's
what's
right.
The question?
Is Esau part of the Gentiles?
Yeah, Esau is a Gentile. All non-Israelite nations are called Gentiles, strangers in the Bible, heathens in the Bible, dogs in the Bible, right? That's just what the Lord calls them, okay? Remember, to be an Israelite means it's a nationality, it's a bloodline, all right? So do that mean that all people that look my color are Israelites? No, it don't mean that. Because you may not descend from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Does that mean that everyone walking around with pale skin are natural Gentiles? No. They may actually descend from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Why? Because when you look at so-called blacks, we can produce any shade of color, any shade of brown.
Right.
We can produce anything, right? All right? So read what you got.
First Esdras chapter 8, verse 69. The nation of Israel, the princes, the priests, and Levites have not put away from them the strange people of the land, nor the pollution of the Gentiles.
Of the who?
Of the Gentiles.
Of the what?
Of the Gentiles.
What are the pollutions of the Gentiles? This one coming up, Halloween.
Right.
Halloween is a pollution of the Gentiles.
Right.
A lot of you blacks are going, some of y'all right now got pumpkins in your window. Scarecrows on your porch with missing feet and heads.
Teach.
Y'all stocking up the candy for the kids to come. Where we get that from? We got that from the Gentiles.
That's right.
That's paganism. They taught us Halloween. They used that to worship their God. But what do they tell us? Oh, it's for the kids. Oh, it's not. It's fun. It's trick or treat. It's for the children. That's deceitful and wickedness. Call it what it is. It's a pagan ritual.
That's right.
That's just what it is. Why am I trying to cover? Well, God said, "Why woe to them that call evil good and good evil? Why am I gonna take something that's evil and try and make it good? Do that make sense to you, brother?" All right. These are customs of the Gentiles. So the Israelites are gonna be saved. You understand that? Okay, what was the other question? What was it going?
That was it. I just want to know about Esau. That's it.
About Esau?
Yeah.
Okay. So did that answer your question? All right, it was another brother too. He was good. All right. So let's talk about Halloween. Give me Colossians 2 and 8. Hey, my brother, did you get your question answered? You get your question answered? All right, Colossians 2 and 8. Colossians 2 and 8, real quick. Read. All praise to the Most High through Kendrick Lamar. This truth is spreading. The truth is spreading in these last days. God is using whoever and whatever he can to wake up the 12 tribes of the nation of Israel.
That's right. Colossians chapter 2, verse 8. Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world, and not after Christ.
So my brother, I'm sorry, I didn't get your name. Rufus. All right, Rufus, read it again from the top.
Beware lest any man spoil you.
That word beware, what does that mean? Beware. My sisters, my brothers, y'all got 5 minutes to listen. What does the word beware mean? Be on the lookout. Be cautious. Be on alert. Be on alert that what? Read.
Beware lest any man spoil you.
Lest any man spoil you. Read. Spoil means to destroy you mentally.
Hey.
All right? Read.
Through philosophy.
Through what?
Philosophy.
Through what?
Philosophy.
A philosophy is Halloween. Trick or treat, pumpkins, decorations, masks. That's a philosophy. Read.
And vain deceit.
And what?
And vain deceit.
And lies that don't profit you nothing. What are we going to get out of Halloween? Kids kidnapped, kids hurt, murder, death. That's what's coming behind Halloween. Behind those Snicker bars and those Kit Kats. Somebody going to get kidnapped. Somebody going to get sex trafficked. Because everybody's going to be in masks, running around, acting crazy. Drugs. I remember when I was coming up, they had, we was looking out. They was putting razor blades in the apples. So y'all remember that?
Yep.
They was putting razor blades in the apples on Halloween. So if we wasn't keeping that tradition, would we have to worry about them putting razor blades in apples? No, because we're not supposed to be doing it anyway. All right, read it again.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit, after the tradition of men, after the rudiments of the world.
After the rudiments of this world. Because remember, we are in this world, but we are not of this world.
That's right.
You blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans, you are the Israelites. That's you are right. Not of this world. Read.
And not after Christ.
But not after who?
Not after Christ.
Because did Christ celebrate Halloween? No. You think if Christ was walking the streets in 2020, he'd have a trick-or-treat mask on? But we Christians, we Christ-like. Read on.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy and vain deceit.
So when I look on the south side of Chicago, on the west side, the ghettos, I see a people that's been robbed and spoiled. We've been spoiled of our nationality. We don't know. That's why the prophets is out here to teach us how to live. Give me Numbers 15. That's why we out here to show our people what, how we supposed to eat, how we supposed to talk, how we supposed to walk, dress.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road. Purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.